The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
We welcome you to our New Year's Eve service as we gather this evening. May the peace of our Savior Jesus Christ rest with us now and always. We ask everyone to fill out the cards there in your pews, and after the service, you can leave the cards in the plates at the entrances to the church. Before we do anything else, let's take a moment to greet the folks around you. In our announcements, there will be no Saturday service tomorrow for New Year's Day, but we will have our normal Sunday service times at 8:15 and 10:45 this Sunday. And if you ordered a poinsettia, feel free to take one home with you after the service tonight or sometime next week. Our service this evening is printed in your bulletin, and we begin with our opening hymn, hymn number 881. The Lord Almighty grant us a quiet night and peace at the last.
Amen.
It is good to give thanks to the Lord, to sing praise to your name, O Most High, to herald your love in the morning, your truth at the close of the day. Holy and gracious God, I confess that I have sinned against you this day. Some of my sins I know, the thoughts and words and deeds of which I am ashamed, but some is known only to you. In the name of Jesus Christ, I ask forgiveness. Deliver and restore me that I may rest in peace. By the mercy of God, we are redeemed by Jesus Christ, and in him we are forgiven. We now rest in his peace and rise in the morning to serve him.
Amen.
From Psalm 90. May the favor of the Lord our God rest upon us. Establish the work of our hands for us. Yes, establish the work of our hands. Lord, you have been our dwelling place throughout all generations. Before the mountains were born or you brought forth the world, from everlasting to everlasting, you are God. You turn men back to dust, saying, "Return to dust, O sons of men." For 1,000 years in your sight are like a day that has just gone by, or like a watch in the night. You sweep men away in the sleep of death. They are like the new grass of the morning. Though in the morning it springs up new, by evening it is dry and withered. We are consumed by your anger and terrified by your indignation. You have set our iniquities before you, our secret sins in the light of your presence. All our days pass away under your wrath. We finish our years with a moan. The length of our days is 70 years or 80 if we have the strength. Yet their span is but trouble and sorrow, for they quickly pass and we fly away. Who knows the power of your anger? For your wrath is as great as the fear that is due you. Teach us to number our days aright, that we may gain a heart of wisdom. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. May the favor of the Lord our God rest upon us. Establish the work of our hands for us. Yes, establish the work of our hands. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Eternal God, we commit to your mercy and forgiveness the year now ending, and commend to your blessing and love the times yet to come. In this new year, abide among us with your Holy Spirit, that we may always trust in the saving name of our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
You may be seated. Our Old Testament reading, which is also the basis for the sermon, comes from the prophet Isaiah in chapter 30. For thus said the Lord God, the Holy One of Israel, in returning and rest you shall be saved. In quietness and trust shall be your strength. But you were unwilling, and you said, "No, we will flee upon horses." Therefore you shall flee away, and we will ride upon swift steeds. Therefore your pursuers shall be swift. 1,000 shall flee at the threat of one, at the threat of 5 you shall flee, till you are left like a flagstaff on the top of the mountain, like a signal on a hill. Therefore, the Lord waits to be gracious to you, and therefore he exalts himself to show mercy to you. For the Lord is a God of justice. Blessed are all those who wait for him. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Our epistle lesson comes from St. Paul's letter to the Romans in chapter 8. If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but gave him up for us all, how will he not also with him graciously give us all things? Who shall bring any charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is to condemn? Christ Jesus is the one who died, more than that, who was raised, who is at the right hand of God, who indeed is interceding for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or danger or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are being killed all the day long. We are regarded as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels nor rulers, nor things present nor things to come, nor powers, nor height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. We continue with hymn 891. We now rise for the Holy Gospel. The Holy Gospel according to St. Luke, the 12th chapter, beginning at the 35th verse. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus here is speaking. Stay dressed for action and keep your lamps burning and be like men who are waiting for their master to come home from the wedding feast so that they may open the door to him at once when he comes and knocks. Blessed are those servants whom the master finds awake when he comes. Truly I say to you, he will dress himself for service and have them recline at table, and he will come and serve them. If he comes in the second watch or in the third and finds them awake, blessed are those servants. But know this, that if the master of the house had known at what hour the thief was coming, he would not have left his house be broken into. You also must be ready, for the Son of Man is coming at an hour you do not expect. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
We confess the Christian faith with the words of the Apostles' Creed.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The hymn of the day is hymn 899, and you may be seated.
Thank you.
Grace, mercy, and peace to you from God our Father, and from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Our text this evening comes from Isaiah chapter 30 in the Pew Bible. This is found on page 702, and I'll read again a portion of verse 15. In returning and rest, you shall be saved. In quietness and in trust shall be your strength. And let us pray. O Lord, our Heavenly Father, as we quickly approach a brand new year, we realize that the years are as nothing to you, and that you are timeless, and yet in your love and mercy you entered our time in the person of your Son to bring about our redemption and our help in time of need. And so we pray, whatever fears and sorrows we may be bringing with us into this new year, that you would carry this burden and enable us to have your peace and joy through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Well, here we are. We're almost at a brand new year. And what a wild ride the last year or two has been. And sometimes I think we are our own worst enemies. I'm feeling a little bit like Israel is being described here in Isaiah chapter 30 in 16, where they have been trusting in their earthly alliances, figuring that somehow those earthly alliances would result in their salvation and that they don't really need the Lord's help. And so they declare that we will flee or fly upon horses. In other words, we will have these swift steeds that will carry us into battle and we will be victorious. And yet the Lord says to them, therefore you shall flee away like scared rabbits. That a thousand shall flee at the threat of one, and at the threat of five you shall flee till you are left like a flagstaff on top of a mountain, isolated and alone. And boy, isolated and alone sure describes a lot of people in these last 2 years. We thought we were all that bold. We thought that we could trust the science for answers, and certainly it does give us some, but we also have gotten a lot of confusion. And uncertainty. And I think for many of us, we've missed the most important part of not just entering a brand new year and leaving an old year behind, but how to live out all our years. In chapter 30 at verse 15, thus says the Lord God, the Holy One of Israel, and he makes this remarkable statement, in returning and rest you shall be saved. See, they're looking toward war and to political alliances and to earthly power and the clenched fist. But that's not what's going to bring them their salvation. That's not what's going to preserve them as a people. In returning to the Lord and in rest, and the Hebrew there is Sabbath, you shall be saved. And in quietness and in trust shall be your strength. But who is the quietness and trust to be in? In the Lord God himself. Jesus says, come unto me, all you who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. I think too many of us have labored and are heavy laden under fear, anxiety, uncertainty, and all of the number of things that have been marking this past year. And we cry out to God for help, but we're really not ready for his help. We're ready for him to help the way we want him to help. That's why at the very end of 15 and into 16, you were unwilling and you said, no, we will flee upon horses. Our salvation is not going to be in returning and rest or in quietness and trust. That's weakness. But the reality is a seemingly passive reliance on the Lord is not weakness. It is absolute strength. And again, think of Jesus in the Garden of Gethsemane as he prayed, Father, if there be any way possible, let this cup pass from me. The cup of suffering, the cup of the cross, the cup of death, the cup of bearing the sins of the world, let it pass from me if there's any other way possible. Nevertheless, he said, he prayed, not my will, but thy will be done. That is that quietness and trust. That was Jesus' strength as the Son of God in his humanity, as he was willing to go the way his heavenly Father led him. and in going to the cross and dying for our sins, now we have, as Paul talks about in Romans 8, we have the one who is interceding for us. We have the one who gave his son, who knows how then to take care of all the other parts of our lives in his way, maybe not in our ways. Coming into a new year is always a hopeful time. But if we're coming into the new year, again, only looking towards earthly solutions and earthly plans and earthly desires, we're going to be heartbroken and at odds and anxious for the next for the next year as well. But as the hymn says, with the Lord begin thy task. With this new year, begin it with Christ, coming to, returning to him and finding our rest in him. The rest that comes for the fact that Christ dying for our sins has reconciled us to our Heavenly Father. That whatever is going on in the world, it may be the judgments of God calling sinners to repentance, but he is also assuring his Christians that even though you are going through some of this as well, I am with you always. And he sealed that promise in blood. The blood shed for you. The blood of Jesus Christ, God's Son, that cleanses us from all sin. That's what Scripture promises. That's what God declares. And so here, in quietness and in trust shall be your strength. We're told in Scripture, wait upon the Lord. Or in Psalm 46, be still and know that I am God. And it is when we finally be quiet, open our ears, our minds, and our hearts to God's word, that we will really find our strength. We will really find our peace. And yeah, when the whole world is going nuts, we can have a true rest in our heart because we know who our Heavenly Father is. We know what our true home is with him in heaven. We know that Christ has loved us with his life and has redeemed us. And that even in the midst of these things, though, as I was talking about with someone earlier, we may have to go through the meat grinder again this year. Our Lord went through it first, and he is with us even now. And this new year does not have to be a year of dread, even if the COVID cooties won't let go yet. It doesn't have to be a year of dread, because we enter this year with Christ. We live our day-to-day lives in Christ. And when he calls us out of this life, we can depart in peace and joy with Christ. He was with us this last year, whether we saw him there, recognized him there or not. He's been with us ever since we have been baptized, whether we've recognized it or not. He is with us this evening, comforting us in his word, soon to give us his true body and blood for the forgiveness of our sins, to strengthen us as we go into this new year, because we will go into this year having returned to the Lord our God, finding our rest in him and in the salvation he has provided for us, and quietly trusting in him to be our strength for what may come and for all the joys that we will have this year. God be praised. We're entering a brand new year with Jesus. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep each of your hearts and minds in true faith to life eternal. Amen.
Thank you.
In our prayers this evening, we pray for Inez Buchholz, who is hospitalized, for Heather Hess recovering from surgery, for Mike Southworth in hospice, for Rick Conkergood, Diane Kuhl, Sue Huttinger, Ken and Nancy Bush, Tony O'Neill, and Walt Montney in their illnesses. And our prayers of sympathy for the family of Shannon Huttinger, who passed away this morning. Funeral arrangements are pending at this time. And for the families of Don Ventura and Dale Collison, both of whom were recently laid to rest. At the conclusion of our prayers, we continue then with the service of the sacrament. Let us rise for prayer. O Lord, our Heavenly Father, we leave this past year behind us with its joys and with its sorrows, and we take many of the lessons with us into this new year. But we pray, O Lord, that you would remove any fear or anxiety or sorrows from our hearts, that in rest and in quietness we may behold your salvation for us again in our Lord Jesus Christ, and that our strength would be in you and in the power of your word upholding us through the gospel, through faith in Jesus. Dear Lord, we commend this new year into your care. Help us to live it as your Christians in faith and to be your lights to those around us. Be with Inez as she is hospitalized, that you would grant healing to her and help in her time of need. We thank you that Heather has come through her surgery and pray your blessing upon her recovery. Be with Mike as he continues in hospice care. Bless him, O Lord, and uphold his faith. Be with Rick and Diane, Sue, Ken and Nancy, Tony and Walt in their adversities. Comfort them, O Lord, strengthen them, and grant healing according to your will. And we pray, dear Heavenly Father, that you would be with the families of Shannon, Don, and Dale, whose souls you have called out of this life and home to yourself. We thank you for the life that you have given to them in this world and the life that is theirs in Christ for all eternity. In this time and season, O Lord, we pray your peace and comfort, even in the midst of our sorrows, that those sorrows would be tempered with the joy of our salvation in Christ and the full assurance that neither death nor life nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from your love that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. And so we commend all for whom we pray into your hands, thankful for your gifts, your mercy, and grace through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks unto the Lord our God. It is truly meet, right, and salutary that we should at all times and in all places give thanks to you, Holy Lord, Almighty Father, everlasting God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. For in the mystery of the Word made flesh, you have given us a new revelation of your glory, that seeing you in the person of your Son, we may know and love those things which are not seen. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify your glorious name, evermore praising you and saying, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Our Lord Jesus Christ, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me." In the same way also, he took the cup after supper. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. This do as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Jesus Christ, strengthen and preserve you in body and in soul unto life everlasting. Depart in peace. Amen. Thank you.
Our service continues with the singing of the Nunc Dimittis, and we rise. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Let us pray. O God the Father, the fountain and source of all goodness, who in loving kindness sent your only begotten Son into the flesh, we thank you that for his sake you have given us pardon and peace in this sacrament. And we ask you not to forsake your children, but always to rule our hearts and minds by your Holy Spirit, that we may be enabled constantly to serve you through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. The Lord be with you. Bless we the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace.